I ended up becoming an amputee as a complication resulting from diabetes.
George Bruner's leg was amputated below the knee last year after antibiotics failed to control an infection in his foot.
For me, the most disturbing aspect was the thought of regaining my independence.
To his surprise, a prosthesis has helped give Bruner a normal life. But it was a long road, requiring months of physical therapy and fittings to make sure the artificial limb fit properly.
It took probably 2 to 3 months before I was walking with some confidence.
As Bruner reflects on his own struggle as an amputee, hundreds, if not thousands, of Haitians are losing limbs, the result of crush injuries and infections.
That's catastrophic, especially for a country that size.
Hannah Osborne works with artificial limb patients at Hanger Orthopedics Group. She says having a limb amputated is a long process requiring months of care to make sure there aren't infections and to make sure prosthetics fit. She worries there won't be enough people caring for the Haitian amputees.
There's a lot of follow-up appointments, adjustments that can be made afterwards. It's very important to keep the care there.
Hanger's chairman, Ivan Sable, announced today that the group is donating $250,000 to two different organizations, Physicians for Peace and Project Hope. These groups will help care for Haiti's amputees.
I've heard reports on TV that they're using fence posts, they're using tree limbs, anything they can get their hands on to stabilize impaired or crushed limbs.
Sable says they hope to give more money in the future, even sending their own team to Haiti to help with rehabilitation.